So we're going to talk about using the Iferror function to remove annoying error messages when your drag formula is down. So here we have a parts list and the prices to go with the parts list. So they've entered the serial number of the part that they're looking for and the quantity here. So using the Vlookup, we're going to figure out how much this item costs. So we'll go equals Vlookup, and we're going to select the serial number, and we're going to go comma, and we're going to select the table that it comes from, and then we're going to go comma, and then the price is in the second column, so we'll put 2 there, and it works fine. So there you have the price for that particular item is $25.25. So once again, you can click on this, and because you're trying to set this up in for an invoice or something related to that, you wouldn't want to have to drag it down every time. So let's just drag this down. And it works fine when you have the second serial number and entered in here, and it gives you a price of 19. But because you have nothing entered in here, you have an NA, 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 which is a little annoying. So we want to clean up our invoice form here. So let's put an if error on this formula. So in front of the, we'll click on the top cell here, in front of the VLOOKUP, we're going to type in if error. So if error is going to say, if you return an error, what I'm going to tell you to do is just give me a blank. So I'm going to put 2 quotation marks, and then I'm going to close the bracket, and I'm going to press enter. And so what we do is we click this and drag it down, and that clears up our annoying little error messages here. So let's try this again. So we're going to figure out how much this is going to cost. So what we're going to do is we're going to simply take the price times the quantity they requested. And there you see it's $126.25, and it's totaling for us on the bottom here. So what we can do, of course, is drag this down. Now, because there's nothing in these fields here, we're going to get an error message value for these other one. And also it affects our total because we're going to have, it's in can't add this, I got error messages above there. So once again, let's go up and let's fix up this formula so we don't have those annoying error messages. So in front of the I2, we're going to put in the if error. So if this produces an error, what I'm going to ask it to do is give me a blank, thanks very much. And I'm going to close the bracket and press enter. So let's drag that down. So there we have our formulas that don't have the error, and look at here, because we don't have the error, our total is working. So that is the if error function added to your formulas. Please subscribe.